IBB Beach Volleyball Swatch World Tour live coverage from Moscow, Russia, the capital of this huge, great country, hosting the Grand Slam for yet another year. A sunny Moscow a little earlier on in the week. Sounds have come in today for men's final 4 day. We treated to a wonderful match already in the semi-final. Brazil beating China by 2-0. Switzerland versus the USA. Our next match of the day. Plenty of links between the players. Weather has improved slightly since this morning. It was raining. Temperature dropping a little more. It's 20 degrees Celsius out there now. Rain that thankfully for the moment has stopped. Things are drying off a little. Switzerland, Jefferson Belaguarda. Gordon has represented Brazil before, since being resident in for quite a while now, along with Patrick Heuscher, the surprise package of this Moscow Grand Slam. And a really fight to get to semi-finals. The team who have been in top form for the last 18 months or so. Beijing Olympic Games in 2008 as well. Had a bit of a dip in form after that. Back last year with a bang. This year, it hasn't gone as they would have liked. Injury to Phil Dauhauser, who was in fact born in the country he will face off against today. Time to introduce the official before we get going. It's a very good Moscow afternoon to Maria Villas-Boas of Brazil. She'll be assisted by the European representative, Robert Bronisch from Poland. The teams are about to be welcomed on the court by those who brave the elements this morning. Jefferson Belaguarda in top serving form yesterday evening. They managed to get past the Brazilian team of Arley and Thiago. Patrick Heuscher, very experienced man on the Swatch FIBB World Tour. Probably playing with Sasha Heyer, change in partnership this year. No change though required between these two men. So experienced together, so successful together. Tom the Professor Rogers, a big part of this team. Santa Barbara, California. Man born in Baden, Switzerland, the team against which you will face today. Now resident in California. And what's his life growing up in the States? Philip Dauhauser, Finn Beast. Hasn't been on great form recently. Ankle injury has been troubling him. Let's see what he's got in the tank today. I can tell you the Americans took the first little victory. They won the coin toss. They have elected to receive and attempt to side out first. Jefferson Belaguarda of Switzerland will send across the first serve and left to right. Swiss in all white. The crowd begin to create the atmosphere. Belaguarda serve targets Todd Rogers. Nobody wants to be up against Phil Dauhauser if they get. Todd Rogers does the trick for them there. Nice spike looking for the angle. Belaguarda couldn't deal with it. Teams will be using in this match. Both teams successfully signing out. Well, the Swiss have already been beaten once this week. They lost their final pool play match to the fifth seeded side, as I say, from Poland. The final 2 weeks ago in Stavanger, Bielek and Pruden. Three set match it was. Went very, very close, but apart from that, in top form. Some big seeded teams. They pick up a point. They only after the 16th, Lindberg and Kuning, who invariably played very, very well in this Moscow tournament, on for a couple of years ago. As we see the forced error there from Todd Rogers. coming, puts Rogers under pressure. Maguire was there, Oyshire wasn't forthcoming. The Saints, who are unbeaten this week, have to serve back. Ball, but it squeezes over. Oyshire looking to respond. Gets the better of Big Phil. Bela Guarda, born in Salvador, Brazil. The serving was a big, big part of their victory yesterday against Ali and Thiago. Picture that they might not have attained had Brazilians not blown it all up. What about that in a moment? See Bela Guarda attacking, and there's the first evidence of the thin beast at work. Little grimace as lifts away on that angle. Job well done. Not physically at his best, Phil Dawes. Hasn't been since before the World Championships, really. But he's got two out of two, and this is where it could get very, very dangerous for Switzerland. As a consummate professional, of course, born in Switzerland, based in the United States, I'm sure his mind concentrating fully on the job. Still has family that lives over in Switzerland. Well, well, well.
Sorry, I didn't see, but he calls. I cannot do nothing. Go, please. Okay?
A bit of confusion. Looks as though the last point's been given back to Switzerland. Referee apologising, saying she didn't see the call early enough. The States already thought they'd won the point. At the end of a replay. I'll tell you any more than that. Oyshire it is. Hazard's up now. I only think that it was a net touch from Dahazard that forced the United States to lose the last point. Not very close to the net. In the meantime, Switzerland have edged out an early lead. Nice hit. Nice hit from Don Rogers. And the USA looking to reach their second final succession. Haven't won all the way since Shanghai, though. They were victorious at Brasilia and Shanghai. Second in Stavro, beaten by the world champions. Ninth at the world championships themselves in Rome, which is a big disappointment to them, following that injury to Big Phil. Bela Guarda. Nice and push, cutting across the net. First out of big frame of Dan Hazard to beat, then Rogers is lurking. Guarda and Hoyce are no show, but they're not just turning up here. They want gold. A very disappointing 17th place finish at home in Stade last week. It's not their first final four together though. Together in Beijing, and it's third on that occasion. Click this year. That ball there was in the final four a couple of years ago in Moscow, then playing with Martin Latziger. They continue to side out. One lead is being held nicely here. There goes Hoyshire. Rogers looks for Dahlhauser. Bela Guarda's there, has to be rescued this one. Rogers now looks to finish off, but that is a rescue job. Brought full circle very nicely indeed by the States. First little time that they're under pressure. conceded a foul at the net for Dahlhauser. I'll say that that was the case. Big Phil goes long though. 8-6. That's Switzerland. That's about habit at the moment. Sure at the net though, and Rogers can't even get it beyond the net. Big presence on the 34-year-old from Bronfeld in Switzerland. What would be, you could see, going around it, just a miscalculated effort on the ball that he needed to put up. 9-6, this is just very good for Switzerland. And now this time it's Big Phil that makes the error. Dear, oh dear, oh dear. Well, the USA not turning up at all at the minute. Very interesting that Nip and Hawkins coinciding with that injury. Fifth in Beijing, ninth at the Worlds, fifth in Stavanger. Back to the final.
You should keep 12.
Those three results, they've been in the final every time this season.
Get the ball behind you.
Any confusion? Change on the ball. Yeah, of course, instructing Melo Guarda.
Go.
Left to take the ball from. And the cut shot this time does its job. Well calculated by the professor. He needed that, it's not Rogers. The USA as a team needed that. It's three for the last few points. Up for Bella Guarda. Indoors Rogers. There's an error in it. Net touch by Phil Dahlhauser. Not for the first time today. Technical timeout. The USA are 5 points down to this man and his partner. Bella Guarda on your screen. Hoischer already got a sit down. Very, very comfortable in what he's done so far. And as Rogers and Dahlhauser move off, they have some thinking and some coming back to do in this first set. Interesting looking at the head-to-head between these two teams. There's always been a bit of a fight. Third match between them. The USA have won both previous encounters. We see the alternative entertainment on court now. They've done every previous match between these two teams. All the three sets. should be in and trapping ourselves in for the long haul here. Really hope so. It's not entertainment so far. Trees, but nobody really expected them to get into a couple of final fours halfway through the season. With the quality there is on show. Aguardas there has to avoid touching the net. It's a very classy poke. And the Swiss maintaining the lead, even extending it 15-9 here. Rarely you see the Americans embarrassed in a set. That's what could be happening. Issue with the floats down the middle. Rogers takes control and finishes quite quickly too. Nicely done. Wonderful jump serve. It's brilliantly dug out, though. Yeah. Chance to finish it off. And does so. Well, the serve deserved that. 81.5 kilometers per hour, you can see. Down diving to his right. That one that was good. Timeout taken. First sniff of any sort of form from Phil Dahlhauser. And the Swiss try to stop him in his tracks. Those of you don't watch Phil and Tom week in, week out, you might not know. Once they get going, it's almost impossible to stop. Swiss very sensibly, even though they're ahead here, and ahead quite comfortably in this first set, do not want to let the Americans back into it. Dahlhauser, with his jump serve, can be extremely dangerous. We've seen him send down ace after ace after ace in previous matches over the last few years on this Swatch World Tour. Hello. Russian crowd. Enjoying the fact that the sunshine has poked its head through the clouds. Players free to play. Just their shirts. In the first semi-final, everybody was all dressed in the hugged up in lycra. Trying to keep warm and trying to keep dry. 4 points down here at set one. Dahlhauser resumes service. Again, it's a decent serve, good power. And a great opportunity for himself. It's a touch on the net by Bellaguarda. Well, is this one of those big Phil rolls that we see? He's shown he's there on the last couple of serves. There's the net touch, quite clear.
He called them already net, but was no net. Two net calls without...
Yellow card, showing no direction for protesting the magic motion. Yeah. Once again, this time the sting's taken out of it well by Bella Guarda, who rises, looks to finish. Oh, roll shot down the line. So important that Switzerland side it out there. Not just for the numbers, which are still firmly in their favour, but for confidence. There's a real way of fighting American momentum. 16-12. James takes Bella Guarda to the left as he serves here. Cross court in towards Rogers.
No.
Rogers on his own, no one to cry. Oh, Bella Guarda's down there. Oh, it's a poor strike. Not made easy for him. First bit of defense was brilliant. Washington didn't nearly help him out enough. It came and surprised him as well. Bella Guarda looking to drop it beyond. He's concentrated. Making sure the rally was alive. Rogers to serve. Guarda. Pops up looking for Heuscher. Rogers. Now this is a chance for the States. Rogers with a swing. It is called in. Our first chance in this match that the Americans have started to have a stiff. Swiss beginning to worry, they've used the timeout already. Send it across to Heuscher. Nice bump up. The roll needed to be good. Just beyond the block of Phil Dauhauser, reaching across. Let's have another look. There he goes. Leaving too much of the line exposed, really. And the quick look back at Rogers as if to say, well, where were you? Rogers there. So was Heuscher. The American had the beating of it there. Now the American signing out to come to within two. Still not quite good enough as we approach the business end of the set. But they're winning with a shout, I guess. They're just starting to click. And just before it's too late as well. Again, the serve not quite as powerful. Heuscher can deal with it. And there is Big Phil with a block, but blocking out. We made two really good ones early on in the set. He's been a bit quiet on that front. It's not giving him a stiff. Okay. Can celebrate though. Then I go out of that. Long in towards the angle, in towards Todd Rogers, who now rises looking for a swing of his own. Goes long. And is that the set that just slips away from them? Big, big error there from Todd Rogers. Normally dishes out lessons, the professor. That was how not to swipe, given a free hit.
Goes.
Looks to repair. Heuscher's there. Deemed as legal, the touch by the referee. And Switzerland hammering down the centre through Patrick Heuscher to bring up a set point. Now we really have a game on. Dauhauser reaching to his left. Contact, to a legal one at least, almost impossible from there. Set point it is. Americans justifiably not happy with the way they play, but Switzerland have been on top form here. Bella Guarda serving for their reward, which would be a set lead in the semi-final. Rogers up for Dauhauser. Goes long, it's right on the line. They side out to save the first one. But they have an almighty job on their hands here, Todd and Phil. If they're to save this first set. Four set points needed to defend. And they're forced to serve. Rogers it is. Goes long. Watched all the way by Heuscher. Down, it's set up nicely. There's the roll shot. There's the first set. 21-16, the Swiss on fire. And quite deservedly taking the lead in the semi-final. And they have support too, which is good to see. Now talk about entertainment. 21-16. Almost let it slip in that quarter-final yesterday against Brazil. In the end, they stayed hard, they worked hard, they hung in there, got their chance and took it. Today they've had plenty of chances and taken virtually all of them. Americans appearing all too intermittently in the first set. No real consistency from Rodgers and Dahaza. Laguarda and Heuscher are performing very, very well indeed. Set two on the way then. Walsh has got a strike, goes long. Good start for the Americans who win the first set point on serve. Point of the set, I should say. The noise being made by this ever-growing crowd, which is good, good atmosphere. Into the poor weather, and Heuscher responds for Switzerland. We've already seen a couple of Swiss flags dotting about. Really want to put the disappointment of their Stade performance behind them. They've been coming into form. They had that final four in Beijing at the Grand Slam. 317 places. Disappointed for them. Off from that, they've been in and around. They carry on the second half of the season, whatever happens in the semi-final. Swiss really had to be considered a success. Certainly not as strong as they were 10, 15 years ago. The Americans are Olympic champions, remember. The world champions as well, this pairing. World championship in Switzerland. Incidentally. Rodgers up for Dahlhauser, looks to make it 3-1, there's the roll, and they're on it. Dahlhauser is there, Rodgers. Oh, brilliant, absolutely brilliant for the United States. Now they've turned up. Perhaps it just needed that first set loss to get them angry enough. Dahlhauser winning that point almost on his own. There he is with the serve. Can he do the damage? Your answer for the moment. Not a positive one. Rodgers. Towards Belaguarda. Rolls it wide. Oh, what's happened to the Swiss challenge now? Maybe a bit of jangly nerves once they realised what a crisp position they were in. Yeah, they played it on three set matches this week. Lost to Poland in three. Won to Brazil in three. They had to hang in there. The Americans, by the way, they had to go to three sets once. After they lost the second set against Germans Edmund and Matysik. Oh, now it's a poor setting. Double touch called by Belaguarda. Not too much argument from him. America's taking it all 6-2 here. Next down. Just need a foothold in the second set. Oh, course, has pulled it down. Now to looking to rescue it. Finds an obstacle in the way of the chair with that huge swatch net that comes across the court. Americans, though, certainly looking more awake. Please, Randy Stocklos, who's looking on. Going over the United States this week. Heading behind in the coach's position. On the line. Rogers doing very, very nicely. Feet to the great American a moment ago. Stocklos, he was betting on his boys to take gold today. Previous meetings between these two teams have gone to three sets. Be surprised if the Americans hit back. Rogers down. Dahlhauser's there. Well rescued by the Professor Rogers. Almost from below the net there, and he makes the pass. And Dahlhauser's gobbled it up nicely. Looking good this for America. Very, very good indeed. Dahlhauser and Rogers back on form here. Nice strong service target. Dellaguarda to set it up on the angle. They do really well. Really, really well there, the Swiss. The States also had them where they wanted, by the way. They set their defence like that. Dahlhauser looking to block the line. They had Rogers cross court. Guarda, though, just getting the better. It's a good duel. Man from Salvador, talented then. Picked up an FIVB Challenge and Satellite win with Brazil back in 2002. Now playing for Switzerland. Americans, they do have the lead though. The lead that they desperately need to keep here in set two, otherwise they're going to play the bronze medal match. Nice high set from Dahlhauser. Rogers though can't quite make it his. The Swiss back to within two as well. Bellaguarda, this serve doing all the damage yesterday, not quite managing to do the same here in this match. He's down well digging and diving. Set not great for him, and that's the reason why he fails. Like the set even behind him, he wanted it closer to the net in front of him to run onto. Osher failing. See, the Americans will be ahead. Technical timeout is coming up. A few more points to sit down, gather thoughts on how things have gone in this first half of the second set. Dahlhauser, oh, it's called in, it's an ace. Right on the line from Big Phil. a big key point there. That ensures that if they can get another point off serve, they'll have a 5-point lead going into the technical timeout. Nahal's a big ball toss and rise. It's a good rescue there from Hoysha. Oh no, Benaguarda. Oh, his form's gone missing in the last few minutes. Curses to himself as he walks off. Free hit for him there. Well, they swap roles in the second set. The States now looking all together and clicking. Swiss not getting the right start, never really recovering. And one moment when they thought they might well get themselves back in touch. Now you have to fan through the Americans. Crowd enthralled by this match. Great to see they've come in their numbers again despite the poor weather. Look at it, it's changing. It wasn't forecast to do so. We were forecast rain all day, hence the reason that some people might well be watching on television at home and deciding to pop down to the courts that they see the sun shining. Hoping there'll be even more in to fill those few empty seats there are for the bronze and gold medal matches later on this afternoon. Participants of those matches far from certain here. USA are set down against Switzerland in the second semi. 13-8 up here and on the way to a comeback. Dalhauser. Oh, so close again. Right from up here in the commentary position, you can see it was a case of a centimetre or two beyond. It was called just out. Fine line between an ace and a long serve. Service in towards Dahlhauser, peels off, no block. Aguarda's there to take the sting out of the ball. And again, poorly set by Oysha. And Aguarda forced to try and cut it very finely. Nothing's going for them at the minute. High set, that's better. Much, much more methodical from the Swiss. All about trying to create those simple plays just to side out. States not putting them under too much pressure there. And them to get the move together. Cup shot doing its job. Aguarda with a jump serve and serving well off. More points to secure this third in the final. The side it looks is where we're heading. And Aguarda trying to stop that, trying to change the course of the match. Looking for his cut. In the end, sends it long. There we go. Kind of roll on the angle. So he's always willing to take. He hits it so hard, so find the trajectory over the net as well, always seemingly going for that baseline. Many times he gets it right, but you do see a few net serves and net balls from Bill Bauhauser. Don't mind too much, 6 points to the good here in set two. That's an excellent serve there. Oyscha this time on the money, 87.6 kilometers per hour, power, pace and real precision. Look at this again, right between the two of them. That's perfect. We talked about those five lines on the jump serve a moment ago. The other side of that. Roll down the line as Rogers. Now Hauser, Rogers again. Blocked but blocked out. Rogers asking the question if there's a net touch. Oyscha's there, brings out his roll shot. Well, that with a Swiss will be able to muster up anything as far as this set's concerned now. What they are doing is putting some scoring runs together. Just regaining their confidence after the disaster that's been the second set. So in a good frame of mind for the third. Go line, Mr. Cook. Cut onto the line, quite a nice. Set point to the United States. And a whirlwind of action from them in the second set. Much thanks to the serving of Phil Dauhauser. Oyscha. Dauhauser's there, chance for Big Phil to swing for it. There it goes, it's out there. Very, very close. Six opportunities though for the United States, for Rich now to side out for the set. Oyscha will serve for the Swiss. Just about squeezes over. Phil over in two. Job done. And we're going to a third set decider. So two fairly one-sided sets, first in favour of the Swiss, second for the United States, have shown some character and all of their experience to get back in it. That's the scores on the doors. We await the decider as the coin toss is made once more. Rogers, Dauhauser, Bellaguarda, Oyscha, four the protagonists. Three the sets we're going to play here. Two the teams contesting it, just one the team that can progress to the final itself. Living the USA or Switzerland. One opportunity for anybody to take the gold medal. The USA, though, in their quest to contest it, haven't been the greatest of starts. Rogers hits. Rafa Benaguarda looks for his line. Brilliantly saved, though. Dan Hazard thought he might have won the point there. Again, the contact's good. Good defending, solid stuff by the Swiss. And it's their one as well. Well, what a start to set three. Is there life in the Swiss team yet? The Americans coming back awesome in the second set. Same adjective they're used to describe, without doubt, the Swiss defending there. Found the finish well. They're 2-0 up here. Bit of renewed determination and effort from them. Benaguarda. So it's a solid one. Now Hazard deals with it though. And finds his role. Big important point for the United States. They mock the score column for the first time in this third set. Again, matches between these two, not disappointing. Three sets, all of them over 50 minutes. Shanghai, Stavanger, now Moscow. And Switzerland marked their first victory though. Osher, big fill, big block, the block's out. Will go again, makes it. Swiss with still the slight advantage with the side change after every 5 points in these three sets. Deciding sets, decided to maximize any advantage. So need a 15 points. Still two clear points for victory required. Rogers on the serve, the US slightly trailing here. Could serve as well, float serve it as well. Watch them in by Benaguarda. Had to work hard. Well, the Swiss reckon it's in. The line judges thought it was out, the referee said it's in. The Americans on second look. Still looking at it. Let's have a look for herself. Well, camera angle not the best there. To Switzerland. Referee, Maria Villas, of course, keeps it in the way of the European side. Benaguarda starting to find some power on serve. Osher there. Benaguarda, that time it is wide. That time there's no touch, and it's a big, big opportunity miss for Switzerland. Bella having a chance there. States almost think the Swiss in for a three-point lead in the end. Now they backed out of one. Tension beginning to build. So much at stake, of course. Looking for the USA. Gold medals have been scarce for them this year. Oh, well. The set not good enough. Osher hanging about. They're doing more than that, in fact. Taking advantage of it. Big Phil set drifting over. Rogers not the tallest. She was higher. It's his poke that finds the set. Rogers jumps up again. This time it's the joust. Benaguarda. Once more. Very nearly misses his opportunity. But after the touch on the block, the States are left cursing themselves. Can Switzerland really do this? Osher serving at 6-3 up here. Just takes down. Oh well. Double touch. Everything's going against them. Maria Villas-Boas, and well, you don't see Todd Rogers react in an angry way too often. You can tell it's getting to them. Normally so cool, so calm. You heard the cry of what's going on. He's still across the other side of the net contesting it. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Timeout taken. I think they need a heat taking out of the moment or two. Not particularly pleasant language used towards the referee by Todd Rogers. Can understand his frustration, things going against him. Then he gets called for a double touch. Let's have a look. Not able to see, unfortunately, the director not showing us the double touch in question. As he calmed down, needs to get his head back on it because Switzerland 7-3 up. Really, it's their match to lose now. 4 points of difference between these teams. Rogers and Dalhauser need to sort it out. This season when they've been in a final four. Reached the final on every single occasion. Participation in this afternoon showpiece in doubt. Rogers. Osha sets it up nicely. Belaguarda, even though he was there, Big Phil, he was beaten by Belaguarda. Hanging over, blocking the line. It's Rogers' failed spike that allowed Switzerland to set up. Nice cut across. 8-3 now. Osha, decent serve that tested Rogers. Needed some help. Belaguarda's there. Osha goes long, but too long. Oh, what a glorious miss! Well, well, well. Now, did it brilliantly to save that? It could have just been handed a lifeline there. Really should have been 6-point advantage there for the Swiss. Instead, it's 4 down. Belaguarda. Osha, this time gets it right on the angle. Well, from head in his hands to a celebration. How quickly things can change in beach volleyball. Certainly was a powerful spike. Great entertainment here at the Moscow Grand Slam. All down. 9-5. The score advances on. Side-out passage of play, side-out at the minute. Switzerland will be happy about that. Stakes need a run of points off their own serve. Dalhauser could be the man to provide it. It's a decent one. Osha dealt with it well, looks for his roll. Blocks there, but Belaguarda now will have a swing. He's there, down the line, on the line. Not so often that Dalhauser leaves the gap down that line. It was exploited though. Switzerland. Well, without that, this would be the biggest victory of their short career playing together so far. Of course, both very experienced players, both 34, Belaguarda and Hoyscher. Only the seventh event together. I think it's the former world and current Olympic champions. But we want to save. They're still 5 points away from securing it, though. 10-6 as Rogers will now serve. Osha, Belaguarda. Looks for the line. Big cry of come on, come on from Dalhauser. Or Rogers wasn't getting anywhere near it. Lovely roll. Of course, it's anybody can get it over. Big reach of Big Phil. It's then landing it in. It's a big arc required. And that's a roll shot to really save and admire. One that won't happy them, make them happy too much. Because they need much more than that, the States. Still 4 points back here, and time is running out fairly quickly. Need to time an assault on the scoreboard quickly if they're to play the gold medal match. Dalhauser throwing all of his arm and pace into that ball. Well, it didn't allow Switzerland to set it up properly. And Wilder. The most glaring of misses, but not the best of spiking action from him. Now the difference is just three. Real test of Swiss nerve. Now Hauser again. Danger man still on serve. Up towards Belaguarda than now then. Double touch scored against Switzerland. It's certainly starting to get interesting again. I think a hint of the protestation from Hoyser there. Well, you caught one for them, what about us? Well, it did look to be spinning when it came out of his arms. Decent enough call, I think, by the other sports. Spin is a good indication. A poor touch on the ball. Switzerland calling timeout. Hauser on serve. They did in the first set. They managed to save and stop American momentum. They have the minimum advantage at the minute. They can side out now. They get 3 points. They'll feel much more comfortable. But another 4-2 for the Americans here, and it could quickly turn against them. This is the pressure cooker part of the match. This is the moment that will decide it. The crowd know it. Even they look nervous. The United States pulled off a wonderful comeback in the second set. Now down in the third. Contreras from the Swiss really should have put them to the sword. They manage. They're still 2 points up there. Down Hazen Rogers with it all to do. Again, it's a good serve. And Aguarda takes down. Can't really miss with a swing. Well, he didn't, but Big Phil turned up. What a time to come into the match. Dalhauser's there, putting the roof over that spike. And more than well worth another look. Just 1 point behind. It is a contest once more. Dalhauser's serve out. And just takes away a bit of that pressure. Opens the valve slightly. Switzerland had the 2 point advantage again. And for the moment can breathe. No errors allowed from either side. Hoyser in towards Rogers. Slide out from the States. Well, there's no Big Phil to serve here. Rogers needs to do something special. States still require a point off their own serve, at least. Just drops it in front, bit of confusion, nerves starting to tell from the Swiss. Belaguarda, lovely cut across the block of Dalhauser. They're within 2 points of victory here. Well, it's been a while since we've seen a semi-final so hotly contested on the Swatch Tour. Certainly the first this week. That's it. Threw it in. Rogers is there, what a time to come up with a block! And it's brought at match point. Hoyser to the rescue for Switzerland. Just as it looked as though their challenge might be about to crumble when faced against the mind of Dalhauser and Rogers. Rogers attempting a spike. Hoyser reaches over. Match point. Rogers is there. His cut saved the first one. But they still have two more opportunities here. States have to stop Switzerland siding out or it's all over. Phil Dalhauser. No error allowed. Goes long, does he? He does. Lands a couple of centimetres long. A wonderfully well left serve by the Swiss. It secures a memorable victory for them. The biggest win in their 7 events together. These all boys who changed teams. So much experience, but this is a new adventure together. They're in their first gold medal match. They've beaten the former world champions. They've beaten the current Olympic champions by 2 sets to 1. Belaguardanoj are into the Moscow final and will contest the gold medal against the current world champions later on this afternoon. Well, Patrick Kozhev, 34 years of age, 129 tournaments, 58 tournaments for Jefferson Belaguarda, formerly representative of Brazil, now resident in Switzerland, and that lone fan has been left perhaps the happiest man in this stadium. So, preparations for the bronze and gold medal matches already underway here in Moscow. The Grand Slam 2011. Before we go to those, let's have a look at the highlights. Well, Roger's heading down. And of course, it started excellently well for Switzerland. A very, very early advantage in the first set. Now Hauser losing points when you normally expect him to gobble them up. 21-16 in the first set. Switzerland taking it and carrying on good form, having only lost once this week. The Americans had only lost one set up to then, and bounced back well in the second set, taking it 21-14. And of course, having done so, you know, really would have bet on them to take the third two. But the momentum swung back into the Swiss favour. And with that win, after being ahead 15-12 in the third, they secured the 2-1 victory. So that's the final score here at Centre Court in Victory Park in Moscow. Russian capital all set to host the bronze and gold medal finals then. They're coming up a little later on this afternoon. Set your watches to local time, 5 and 6 p.m. That's GMT plus 4. For yet more from the FIVB Beach Volleyball Swatch World Tour 2011.